everyone, welcome back to another episode with Gloria Glitz TV. In today's video, I am going to be showing you how to cook meat in bulk for future use in order to save time while cooking. But before we start, let's take a quick trip to the meat shop.
So guys, I am now at the meat shop. I will be showing you the meat I will be buying. They have different kinds of meat here, but I will buy just one type or two. So let me show you the meat I will buy. Those are the different kinds of meat they have in the shop. They have fresh chicken, and I will be buying cow meat. I don't know what I will add later, but I will just look around and see what I can buy. This is the one I will be buying. How much is a kilo for this?
$6.95.
Okay, a kilo is $6.95. I'll be buying about 5 kilo or 6 kilo. And I'll be buying some cow skin as well. Give me about 5 kilo there.
5 kilo?
Yeah. 4 kilo and mix it with the bone. With that bone. Okay, the price is different. Give me about 4 kilo here. And I will mix it with this very one. I'll mix it with bone because I like bone. Those are the meat they have here. They have different kinds of meat. This very meat is a very nice meat. The meat is a pork meat. They smoked and dried it very well. Normally, I don't eat pork meat because of the excess fat, but this very one is a very nice one. You can use it to prepare anything. And 1 kilo from the cow skin. This is correct fresh chicken though, but I'm not going to be buying any. I have chicken at home.
And then you film like how you buy it.
Yeah, then I film how I buy it and all that.
Hey, good. Yeah.
So guys, I am done buying the meat, so I'll be seeing you guys later. Bye.
So guys, I am back from the market. You know, I showed you guys when I was buying those meat, and this is what I bought from the market today. So let me take something to put them. I'm going to be washing it before we start cooking. All right. Okay. And this is the this one is with bone because I like. Also, and I also buy something like this. I think I didn't show you guys when I was buying this cow skin. I think this one will also last us maybe 2 weeks or 3 weeks before it is finished. I don't know. I'll be showing you guys how I preserve it later. I'm not going to add it together, so let me just take it to where I'm going to wash it.
I'm not going to be using all the meat on this video. I'm going to be keeping some fresh meat to prepare something else. So I just want to show you a little bit how you can save time when you want to prepare anything you want to prepare. If you are new in my channel, thanks for stopping by. After watching this video to the end, subscribe to support Gloria Glitz TV. To my old subscribers, thank you for always coming back to watch. I appreciate you guys. I really love you guys. May God bless you. Guys, I am done washing and it is very clean. I'm not going to be adding the cow skin. I'm going to be using the cow skin for something else. So let's go for the next step. This is the water I'm going to use to cook the beef. The water I've been cooking for a few minutes now. Inside this water is curry powder, thyme, seasoning and the what else? Ginger powder. I added a little bit of ginger powder, guys. So I'll be adding onions, and this is how I slice my onions in a round shape. So I'll be adding onions and scrot bonnet. I'll go ahead and add the cow beef, and I'll allow this to cook. I'm not going to overcook it, guys. So I'll cover it and allow it to cook. The reason why I am using excess water to cook the meat is because I will need the meat stock to cook whatever I want to prepare. I'm back. The meat is ready, so I'm going to put it aside and go for the next step. The reason why I said don't overcook the meat, don't forget you are still going to fry the meat, so the meat is still going to be cooked when frying. And also, the day you are going to use the meat, you are also going to cook the meat. Maybe you want to use it for stew, you want to use it for okra, you want to use it for anything, the meat is still going to cook for a few seconds. I am done, so I'm going to be putting everything in this sack. This sack is a very big sack, so I'll be putting everything inside. Whenever I want to prepare anything, I'll just take the quantity I need. It's just to save time that's the main reason I'm doing this. I do it sometimes. I just buy chicken and I'll just fry the chicken and put it in a sack like this. That's the reason why I have this sack. Sometimes I will just buy fish. I will just buy sometimes a carton of fish. Not all I will use. I will just take half of it and fry it and put it in a sack like this and keep the other ones in the freezer. That's how I do it sometimes. You know, in Europe we are very busy. When you are going to go, when you are back from work, you want to cook fast food. It's just to save time. You understand what I mean? It's just to save time. So if you like this method, you can also do it by cooking your meat and fry it and put it in the freezer. It's also good. Okay, and this is the meat stock. I'm coming, let me show you the meat stock. This is the meat stock. I'm going to be tying the meat stock in something like this. Something like this. So it's still very hot. I'm going to allow it to cool down and I will tie it and something like this and put it inside the freezer. Whenever I want to prepare anything, I just bring out one meat stock, bring out the quantity of the meat I need, and I'm good to go. Whenever I want to prepare, within a few minutes, it is ready. So if you enjoy watching this video, why not give me a huge thumbs up? And if you have not subscribed to my channel, subscribe to see so many videos of Gloria Glean TV. See you in my next video. I love you for watching. Thanks for watching. See you in my next video. Love you all. Bye.